today I would like to explain the definition of the models for the rational homotopy of EN operads. Models. The rational models, the rational homotopy of the EN operads, of the little disk operad of the EN operads. And so, I'm going in the first step to give some kind of a survey of the classical, so the first part of my talk today would be a survey of a classical Sullivan rational homotopy theory of spaces. And I'm going to address the extension to operads in the second step. And so I mentioned yesterday that for EN operads, we have a model which involves some kind of graph complexes. And this is something, so I'm not sure I will eventually be able to explain this topic today. So in some sense, so I'm using the graph models of EN. So in some sense, I'm using two models of EN operad. One which is given by Chevalier-Lundberg-Cochain complexes of the Drinfeld-Connolly algebras, and another one which are given by this graph operads. And the Chevalier-Lundberg-Cochain complexes of the Drinfeld-Connolly algebras are important for the theory, so the first part would be the theory. And the graph models is the object that we are using to carry out our computations. So in some sense, this first part would give the junction between the goal of this, between today's talk and tomorrow's talk. Okay. So eventually, maybe I will either finish this talk today by this description of the graph model, or I will start tomorrow by this description of the graph model. And so, first part, this reminder. Sullivan. Rational homotopy theory. So first step is, so the goal of this rational homotopy theory to define a counterpart of a classical of rationalization of abelian groups that's a product of Q over Z at the space level. So the first I'm going to be more precise on what I mean by a counterpart of this rationalization. Okay. So the first point, we deal with simply short sets. Rather than simply short space, than topological spaces. Just recall this is not a problem because you can use the classical because the category of simply short set has the same homotopy theory as topological spaces by the classical Milner-Kahn equivalence. Okay. This category. So the homotopy theory of simply short sets. Of simply short sets, I'm going to denote by S set as as the same as the homotopy. But so the homotopy theory simply shows sets. Is equivalent to the homotopy theory of topological spaces. Topological spaces. They have a classical minor can. I mean, if you have a simply show set, you can take variation, the geometric realization, to get a topological space. And if you have a topological space, you can take a singular complex to get a simply show set. And these maps are, so now in the language of model categories, they define a Euclidean adjunction. This means that they induce equivalences of categories at the homotopy category level. OK, so it doesn't make any difference if you consider simply show sets rather than topological spaces. And to construct the first step of the Sullivan approach, the construction of a functor, a media star, from the contravariant functor, from the category of simply show sets, the opposite of the category of simply show sets, to the category of DG commutative algebras. Maybe I do know this. So this is the category of cochain DG algebras, commutative algebras. Cochain DG means that these algebras are upper graded. They are concentrated in upper non-negative degrees, and the differential raises degrees by one. Okay. And so this functor is an analog of the Durham cochain DG algebra functor. The main difference is that it is defined over Q and for simply show sets, not only for manifolds. A set of manifolds and over Q. So to define this functor, one first take define the image of a simplices, delta n. These are actually the polynomial of the PL, the piecewise linears, people say, or polynomial of piecewise linears. This is the DG algebra of polynomial PL, differential forms. On the topological simplex, in general, I regard the topological n simplex as the subset of points x1, x2, and xn such that x1 is larger or equal to 0, x2 is larger or equal to 1, x1, and so on, up to xn, which is less or equal to 1. Okay? Inside Rn. So this, and concretely, it's the algebra generated by the coordinates functions x1 xn in degree 0 and the differential forms of this coordinate function, dx1, dxn, which have degree 1. So here, I mean polynomial algebra in the graded sense, which means that this element anti-commute rather than commute. Okay, so equivalently, you could say this is Q, x1, xn, tensor of extra algebra on dx1, dxn. And the collection of this object inherits the structure of a simplicial structure from the collection of the simplices. From the dance. And so this object forms a simplicial object in the category of DG commutative algebra. Now for a simplicial set, I take omega upper star of x to be the set of maps, the set of morphisms in the category of simplicial sets from x dot to omega star delta dot. Okay, so. So just an element omega in omega upper star of x is just a map which to any n simplex of xn assign a form omega sigma in omega upper star delta n. Okay. And with the property that this assignment is compatible or preserve the simplicial structures. And intuitively, this form, so if I identify sigma, then simplex sigma is a map, sigma from delta n to x, map of simplicial sets, then this form just represents the pullback of omega to delta n under sigma. And omega sigma. So the form defined on delta n represents the pullback of omega under this map sigma. Or maybe I should say sigma hat. Okay. So now the proposition that this functor has good properties. So first thing, this functor has a left adjoint. Has a left adjoint, which I denote by G. DG commutative algebras to simplicial sets. is given by a very simple formula. So if I take G, a DG commutative algebra, so the image of a DG commutative algebra under this functor is the set of morphisms of DG commutative algebras from A to omega upper star of delta dots. Okay, so this is a which means that the set of n simplices in GA is the set of DG commutative algebra morphisms from A to omega upper star delta n. And with the simplicial structure is inherited from omega upper star delta dot. Now you have the following theorem. You say that you can use these functors to encode or to understand the rational homotopy of spaces. So first point, the functors G dot and omega star. Oops, sorry. So this functor form a Qn pair. So here I assume that that S set, the Ketterhoff simplicial set, is equipped with the classical Kahn simplicial model structure. And also I consider the standard model structure on cochain DG commutative algebras, where the weak equivalences are the quasi-isomorphisms. Okay. DGCOM. The crypts. Model structure. Such that the weak equivalences. Okay, the set of morphisms, so a map morphism of DG commutative algebras, and the morphisms of DG of the quasi-isomorphisms. So the morphisms of commutative DG algebras which induce an iso in homology. So I'm not going to explain what are the configurations and the configurations. So the main points is that so this allows you to so this basically this says that these functors have good homotopical properties in the sense that they preserve they carry so for instance the functor G carry the weak equivalences between coefferent objects to weak equivalences of simplicial sets and the same thing with omega upper star. Okay. So which means that this allows you to compute things on the homotopy category. The second point, so if X is a good space, so which I should introduce notation. So so this is Sullivan notation for A commutative algebra. I consider the image of L, so G and omega star from a Qn pair means that they have derived functor. And this bracket notation is for the derived functor of G. Okay, so this is the left derived functor of G. And this means that to get this the image of A under this derived functor, you take the image of a coefferent resolution of A in the category of commutative DJ algebras under G. So this is a set of morphisms of DG commutative algebras from RA to omega upper star of delta dot. Okay, so where RA is a coefferent resolution of A. Resolution of A in DG curve. And the fact that that G and omega upper star form a Q(n) pair implies that this mapping doesn't depend on the choice of a coefferent resolution of two homotopy. Okay, so I would like to call this object the geometric realization of the DG commutative algebra. So this is a Sullivan notation. Sullivan has, okay, and so. For the moment, I'm not going to be precise about what the coefferent resolutions are, but we are going to see some explicit example later on. So now, the second main point is that if I consider space, if I assume that x is good enough, which means that if x is q good, in the sense of Bosfield-Kahn, for instance, omnipotent, and the cohomology of X, rational cohomology of X, forms a finitely generated module degree wise. It's finitely generated in each degree. Then, so I can take the image of X under the rationalization. So I get a DG commutative. I can take the image of X under the functor of PL forms and take the realization of these commutative algebras. And the claim is that this object represents a rationalization of X. So this is exactly my rationalization functor on spaces. Of the space, maybe I'll put of the space X. So this means that if I take the homotopy of this space with respect to any base point, then I get the rationalization of the homotopy of X, so the Q localization, in degree larger or equal to 2. And the Maltsev completion of pi 1 of X. Degree 1. Okay, so the Maltsev completion is the analog of the rationalization for non-abelian groups. It's still an algebraic construction. Okay. And so,
what about pi 0?
So yeah, and X is, so this works well if X is connected. Okay, is quite good. Okay, let's. X equals X. Mm-hmm. The theory works well for connected spaces only. Okay. So this really means that you can, so this model, omega upper star of X, which I associate to any simplicial set X, really encode, so it encodes the homotopy of rationalization of X, and this rationalization also captures all the rational homotopy information about X. Okay. So this is why we can use the Sullivan model to carry out computations. So now I would like to give an example of application which is related to my little disk opera, to EN opera. So I would like to consider the configuration spaces. I'm not going to deal with operads for the moment. Example, I consider the space X, the space of configurations of R points in Dn. Okay, so the space of collections. Space whose points are collections or R tuples of R vectors in Dn, which are distinct from each other. Okay, so this is not a simple show set. This is a topological space, but whatever, we can take the singular complex of X to get a simple show set. And we would like to understand the rationalization of this simple show complex, so I can take the geometric realization. So I take the singular complex of X. I apply Verbo's construction to this simplicial set. And so this gives a rationalization or a rationalized space at the space level. And we would like to understand this space. Okay, I can take the geometric realization to recover the topological space. So what is the homotopy type of this space? And actually, I'm not going to consider the cochain algebras or forms for the moment, but rather the cohomology. So reminder. So the cohomology of F Dn circle R is the symmetric algebra generated by elements in degree n minus 1, which are associated to each pair. Divided out by the ideal generated by the vanishing relation, which says that omega ij squared is 0, and the Arnold relation. Okay, where? The Arnold relation. It's omega ij plus omega jk plus omega jk omega ki plus omega ki omega ij is equal to 0. And this is valid for every triple ijk where each of indices which are distinct from each other. Okay. And so what I would like to do is to construct a resolution of this object. Okay, if I take A, so this is a graded commutative algebra. Okay, you can regard this cohomology algebra by H as a DG commutative algebra with a trivial differential, with a zero differential. And the problem is to construct resolution of the coefferent resolution of H. And this is where the Drinfeld-Konos Lie algebra is coming. I consider a Lie algebra. what I'm going to say at the end. Okay. So I take let so the Dunfeld Connolly algebras P and R. So this is the it's a Lie algebra which is defined by it's a graded Lie algebra. And it is defined by generators and relations. So it's a free Lie algebra generated by elements which I denote by T I j, which are again assigned to each pair ij. Modulo some relations, so you have commutation relations and the Young-Baxter relation. Well, so each Cij has degree, so it has a lower degree n minus 2. And or 2 minus n. N minus 2. Cij satisfies the same symmetric properties as the omega ij. Okay. And the commutation relation reads Cij TKL has to be 0. The bracket of Tij and TKL has to be 0. If ij and KL are disjoint, pair ij and KL are disjoint. Okay. And the Young-Baxter relation says that Tij bracket, the bracket of Tij with Tik plus Tjk has to be 0. For all, for every index k which is distinct from I and j. This is the commutation relation, and this is the Young-Baxter relation. Okay, so it's a graded Lie algebra, and so you see the ideal of the. The ideal is generated by quadratic relations. So it says that it also inherits a wide grading from the free Lie algebra. Okay, so this L stands for the free Lie algebra. Wide grading from the free Lie algebra. Because the generators of the relations are homogeneous of wide 2, which relation. So in the case where n equals 2, this Lie algebra is concentrated in differential degree 0. And actually, it represents the graded Lie algebra associated to the purebred groups. Okay. The case where n is 2, PR, P2R, this is the same as the graded Lie algebra associated to a purebred group on R strings. So that's why this Lie algebra is also called the Lie algebra of infinitesimal breaks in this case. Okay. And this relation reflects relation that you have between generators of the purebred groups. Okay. Okay. Now the claim. So what I'm going to do is to consider the Cheval-Ellenberg cochain complex of this DG Lie algebra. Okay. So this is the Cheval-Ellenberg cochain complex of P and R. room here. So this is a symmetric algebra in the graded sense. It is generated by a desuspension of the dual of P and R. Okay, the dual. And the Chevalier-Ellenberg is induced, so it's a DG. So this is the symmetric algebra in the graded sense. So this is the desuspension, so the degree shift. The check stands for the dual. Okay. And the Chevalier-Ellenberg differentials is a derivation of this commutative DG algebra, which is induced by the dual of a bracket map on P and R. The derivation induced by the dual map of the brackets. Bracket induces a map from the, so you can take the external product of P and R with itself to P and R. And this is induced by this derivation is induced by the dual of this map on this DG module. And now the claim is that this Chevalier-Ellenberg-Cochin complex defines a coherent resolution of this DGD algebra. So I think this is due to Kono, maybe in the case n equals 2 at least. So this map maybe I would like to quasi-iso. So, maybe kappa, which goes from this Chevalier-Ellenberg-Cochin complex of P and R to the cohomology of the configuration space, the fractional coefficient, and this map carries so on generators, so it is defined by its action on generators. It carries the dual basis elements of Tij to omega ij. And it vanishes on the dual of basis elements of P and R, which have a weight larger than 1. Okay. The weight pi is larger than 1. So I'm using that this Lie algebra is a white gradient. So it is the map kappa is given by this correspondence in weight 1 and vanishes in weight larger than 1. Okay. And the claim is that is a quasi-iso. And this object defines the coherent resolution of this cohomology algebra. H. get a DG commutative energy. So conformance means that it's a good commutative algebra, and good means that it has essentially, so this is what you get as the class of coherent objects. These objects have to be to form a symmetric algebra if you forget about the differentials. There are also some conditions about the filtration, but that's essentially the point. Okay. And now.
Sorry, can you remind me how the weight gradient works?
Yeah, it's just inherited from the freely algebra. Uh-huh. So you see this, so the degree of the leap polynomial, so the elements are basically leap polynomial, modulo, some relations, so it's just.
Okay, yeah. So it's the degree
of the corresponding leap polynomial. Yeah, exactly. Okay. Yeah. For instance, this one has weight 2, because you have 2, it's a leap polynomial of weight 2. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. And now, so this means that you can compute the variation of this object by using this resolution. And this is a general fact. General. So it's a fact or proposition for Merkle-chain complex. If I compute the variation of this object, so the image of this commutative DG algebras, so on the so D is supposed to be any the algebra. And so if the image of this under the Sullivan realization functor, so you have to compute the DG the morphism set of DG commutative algebra maps from the Schwellenberg-Cochin complex of G to omega per star delta dot. And if you do this computation, because it's a symmetric algebra, commutative DG algebra maps is determined by its restriction to generators. The generators are a degree shift of a dual of G. And you can move the dual to the right-hand side. And basically, what you get is that this simple shell set is identified with a set of forms. So you have to take here, maybe G is infinite dimensional, so maybe you have to take a completion here. So these are forms of degree 1 in the tensor, the completed tensor product of G with the Sullivan Durham cochain DG algebra of the simplices. So here I'm considering forms of degree 1 such that delta omega plus 1/2 of the bracket of omega with itself is 0. Okay. And this is what I call the set of Maurer Carton elements, the simplicial set of Maurer Carton elements in G. Okay, so geometrically, it represents the set of connections which are defined of the, so when simplices of this set are connections which are defined on delta n with values in G. And this equation said that the assume that the connection is flat too. Okay. So the Maurer Carton set of Maurer Carton elements associated to G. Sorry? Oh, G, sorry. Set of Maurer Carton. Values in G. So, as a consequence, if you look at the realization of the cohomology algebra, what you get is a set of more Cartan elements in the with values in the Drinfeld-Konnoli algebras. Okay. So now the claim, so the statement, so it's the formality claim that we actually have. So if I take the cochain DG algebra associated to the singular complex of the computation space. So this cochain DG algebra is actually quasi-isomorphic to the cohomology, to this cohomology algebra. And this is the statement that this cochain DG algebra is formal. It is quasi-isomorphic to its cohomology. And this is equivalent to saying that the rationalization of this space can be represented by the rationalization of this commutative DG algebra. And hence that this set of Maurer Cartan forms on PL. So this was proved by the case where n is 2, n equals 2, this was used rather by Kono, but probably the case where n equals 2, this can be deduced from the Arnold computation of the cohomology, okay, because in that case, in the case where n equals 2, you can use the Arnold representation of your classes omega ij, and you can check that this map actually leads to the cochain DG algebra, to the Durham cochain DG algebra. Okay. And in the case, so this is proved by the case n equals 2 considered used by Kono. The case where n is bigger than 2. So it follows from conservative proof of the formality of a little disk operad, and also from an intrinsic formality statement, which say that I can, so you have this DG commutative algebra quasi-iso. And in fact, the claim is that you can have more. So the claim that we can, that's what I'm going to explain now, we can use an upgrading of a Sullivan cochain DG algebra to get model for operads in topological spaces. And you have more, you have a quasi-iso of this form, which is compatible with operad structures. Okay? Follows from the operadic follows from the formality in the category of operads. Formality of Hopf. I'm going to explain the next part. So this is what. Okay. So the second part, how to extend the Sullivan model to a graph. So that here we face a difficulty. So what I would like to, so omega star is a functor from simplicial set to DG commutative algebras. And what I would like to, so if this functor is contravariant, And what I would like to consider, so it carries operads to co-operads. Okay, so you have to deal with the dual structure of operads. Okay, so I have to deal with co-operads. So what I'm going to do is to consider co-operads in DG commutative algebra, which I call op co-operads, or op DG co-operads. Are corporates, so the dual structure of operads in DG cop. So an element of this category. So it's just a collection of DG commutative algebras. So together with an action of a symmetric group on A1. For each R, and co-product, composition co-product. Circle I star, which go from AK plus L minus 1 to AK tensor AL, which are defined for every for I equals to 1 up to K, which are dual to the dual structure of the composition product of operads. But to handle convergence difficulties, I also need to assume that A naught is K. Is Q, the ground ring, to handle equivalently what one can use a lambda corpus. Which is a way to encode such an assignment. And I will also assume A1 to be Q. This is less significant, but also to simplify the construction as well. So now I want an extension of this functor, which carries an operad in simplicial sets to an object of this form, okay? But now there is a problem. If P is an operad in simplicial sets, so what I can do so I start with omega per star P K plus L minus 1. So I take the image of the composition product of P goes that way. So I take the image of this composition product under the Sullivan functor. And now the problem is that I want to land in the tensor product and not in the omega upper star of the Cartesian product. So I have a Sullivan, the Kunif map, but this map goes in the wrong direction. Okay, it's induced by the product of forms. It's not an iso, but just a quasi-iso. So the problem is that we cannot invert this map to get a co-product which lands in the tensor product. How to invert the equivalences. Okay. So we have a problem with this functor. We can only define an inverse up to homotopy. That inverse map defined. That map defined up to homotopy. K2. So you can you only have a co-product in the homotopy K2, which is not good. But on the other hand, if you look, if you look at the realization functor, then you don't have this problem. Okay. So this is a proposition. And if you look at the functor G, so it satisfies the following properties. G, G dot, which is equal to, so from DG commutative algebra to simple short set, if you look at the adjoint of the Sullivan functor, okay, which is defined by G dot is a set of morphisms of commutative algebra to omega upper star delta. It satisfies, if you take the image of a tensor product under this functor, it's just the Cartesian product. Because of a map of commutative algebra, of differential rate commutative algebras on the tensor product to something is just a pair of maps. So thus, you can use this functor. Thus, if A is a half corpus, then if we take G dot of A, so the collection of a simple short set associated to the components of A, then this collection of simple short sets inherits composition products. So just in that case, you face no problems because you have a co-product. The co-product of A, which goes from A, K, cross the tensor A, L. So we take the image of this co-product under the functor. Get the map that way. And you have a map to the Cartesian product here. And there is no problem because this map is a genuine isomorphism. Okay, so you get a map here. Okay, so that this mapping, G, induces a functor G dot from off co-operads to operad in simple short sets. Now the third claim is that this functor has a left adjoint. A right adjoint, G dot. That functor has a right adjoint. Which means that I have the functor G goes that way. And there exists a functor in the converse direction, which I denote by omega upper star sharp. And I'm going to use this functor as an operadic upgrading and as an operadic replacement of a Sullivan cochain DG algebra functor. Okay. So for that, I have to explain that this functor has good properties. So this goes in two steps. this one is a theorem. The first step, the pair, so G dot of corporates form a QN pair, first spin. So again, this means that you could do homotopy theory with functors. The second point is that if P, I assume that P is an operad in sequential set, it's coherent as an operad. Then, and I need a second assumption, sorry. The cohomology of each PR, of each space PR, the rational cohomology of each space PR, is finitely generated degree-wise. Then, so I can take the op corporate as T2P, the half component of this corporate, so this is a commutative DG algebra on one hand. On the other hand, I have a commutative DG algebra stick to the space PR. Why forget about the operad structure? Then this map is a weak equivalent, it's a quasi-ISO. Okay. And this implies, as a corollary, if I take PQ R, so we take the verb prime, which is given by the generalization of S corporate. Okay, so we got P R. So this defines an operad in simplicial sets, such that the components of these operads are equivalent to the rationalization of each space taken individually. Okay, so I've upgraded the Sullivan rationalization functor to operads. And now to conclude the application to the little disk operad, I'll just do that in. Okay. Two things. The case. P is dn, or the singular complex of dn. If I look at the cohomology, so I can regard the cohomology of the spaces. As an object, so I regard as a DG hop corporad, as a hop DG corporad with a trivial differential. So this STG commutative algebras are equal to the cohomology of the configuration spaces, which I considered in the previously. And the claim is that the maps, so The Drinfeld-Connolly algebra, the collection of the Drinfeld-Connolly algebra, form an operad in the algebra. So which means that you have an action of sigma r on each pn r, and really composition operation, this time are maps from pnk plus pnl. So these are maps of free algebras from this direct sum to pn of k plus l minus 1. Okay. So the composition product are the algebra maps of this form in this case. And this implies that if you take the Schoenberger chain complex, which you get a half DG corpora. The collection of the Schoenberger chain complex. Form an object of the category of DG half corpora. Okay, so we can check that the map induces corporate coproduct on this object. Okay. And so you have two things. So first is a proposition which says that you actually have a quasi-iso from this half corporate the cohomology corporat here, okay, for each n. And the second thing, so we can check that the map, which I defined previously, are corporat maps. And the second thing is a statement, the formality statement for at the half corporat level, which says that if you take omega upper star sharp singular complex of Dn, so maybe we take En. This is the same in the category of Hopf corporate as this DG, this DG corporate. Okay, maybe I should, yeah, I denote it by H also, HDn. Okay. HDn. So this is a quasi-iso in the category of DG of corporate. And this is the same thing as saying that the rationalization of Dn is given by the rationalization of this half DG corporate. So this is equivalent to saying that the rationalization of Dn is the rationalization of this corporate. And you can again use the more Cartan spaces to get a very concrete realization of this object. Okay, so if I stop here, I apologize for it. Thank you very much. Sorry? Yeah, yeah, because to do that, so I have to take the derived functor. So yeah, I've been a bit faster at the end. So Yen, so because if you take the singular complex of Dn, so you get a model of Dn in the category of operads in simply short sets, and En is a coefferent resolution of this object. It's a model of this object, which is coefferent. Okay. This object is well behaved for coefferent operads only. Okay, so in some sense, I could write R of omega plus star for Dn, where R is the derived functor. Well. And there is also an issue because to build the rational homotopy theory, I have to assuming to, for simplicity, that EN1, the prad, are given by a point, one point set in RT1, which is not the case of DN, but you have model of DN which have this property. Okay, so that's why I can use this, this simplifying assumption. Yeah, sure. Yeah, that's a minimal model because the Chevalier, it's a minimal model. Yeah, the rational, in the sense of rational homotopy, right? It's a minimal model because the Chevalier-Lundberg differential, it lands in the decomposable part of a symmetric algebra. It's the dual map of a Lie bracket, so it carries any generator to a product, a twofold tends to a twofold product actually. Okay, so it's decomposable. In fact, so one the claim is that if you know about Kossuth duality of algebras, what you can check, so it's the homology of Dn is a commutative algebra. The Arnold presentation says that it is the quotient of a symmetric algebra by an ideal generated by quadratic relations. And the fact that this commutative algebra is Kossuth. It's Kossuth, maybe if to do Kossuth duality, you have rather to deal associative algebra. In that case, the Kossuth dual, in the sense of the Kossuth duality theory, is the enveloping algebra of this algebra P and R. So next time, I will start with a graph model and explain how we can use the machinery to compute mapping spaces and to get graphs.